Wayne Simmonds. That contract just coming down. Signing with the New Jersey Devils for 1 year at $5 million. Like the fit in Jersey? Jersey has been active and aggressive so far this summer.
Yeah, Wayne was one of those guys, Tangs, and I know you recognize this, that the season didn't necessarily go the way he would have hoped. He'd been kind of clicking along, and Philly fell a little bit out of favor, eventually got moved. Didn't light it up, obviously, in Nashville, was injured, hence the reason why he actually did pretty well, in my opinion, to get $5 million on a one-year deal. It's a risk. Ray Shero knows that, recognizes it. They are short forwards, though, in New Jersey. That's the fact of the matter.
For Wayne Simmonds, it's betting on himself. He's going to be 31 years old when the next, you know, season begin in October, and he's telling himself, hey, maybe some teams are not willing to spend long term on me. Let me prove myself. And that may be the good thing for Ray Shero, because he signed him to a 1 year deal. Yeah, the dollar might have been exceeded a little bit what you should have paid based on the numbers that, you know, Simmonds did last year. But on a 1 year deal, guys are trying to prove themselves. He's going to get the opportunity to play, you know, on one of the top line. He's going to get an opportunity to play on the power play with the New Jersey Devils. And I think for himself, Wayne Simmonds, it could be a good fit playing against some of those young, skilled center icemen in New Jersey.
Just 30 points last year, guys. His lowest in quite some time.
Since his rookie season,
yes.
30 points. How do you see the lines, projected lines? I don't know if we have them built just yet, but we went through it the other day with Jack Hughes and how he kind of fits in. Where do you guys see Wayne Simmonds playing, and where do you see Jack Hughes playing?
Jack Hughes, I would think, would slot in as the second line center. Of course, he's got to go into camp and prove that when it's all said and done. I think Nico Hischier is going to be the first center. Of course, you got Taylor Hall on one side. You got Palmieri on the other. Those guys are going to be effective. What do you think, Tangs, when it's all said and done?
Well, when you look at this list, and we have it right here, Taylor Hall, Nico Hischier, you could put Palmieri or you could put Bratt on that second, you know, on that first slot on the right side. And then for me, the second line, you know, it's probably going to be Travis Zajac, because he's going to be playing some of those top minutes, you know, against the top line on the other side.
I'm thinking more as that shutdown guy, but
exactly, a shutdown, but you put him in a role.
More minutes than the number two.
And if John Hines, what he's going to try to do with Jack Hughes is not unlike what, you know, Mike Babcock did with Austin Matthews. When he's going to be at home, he's going to want to play against the third and fourth line on the other side. He's going to give him the minutes, you know, when he starts on the offensive zone. And to have a guy like maybe like Coleman on his side that's highly dependable, a guy like Wayne Simmonds, you know, who's played the game before with high skill guy, could be a good line for Jack Hughes on the third line. You also have got Miles Wood, but I'd like to see somebody with more, how can I say, hockey IQ, you know, understanding of what Jack Hughes is going to try to do, because Jack Hughes views himself as a goal scorer, as a point producer. You have to put guys beside him that can sniff, you know, the offense and that can feel it a little bit better. I'm curious to see how it plays out, but John Hines, you know, to add a player like that, you know, certainly helps, you know, alleviate the pressure that he's got putting Jack Hughes in a spot in this lineup.
Yeah, going to be interesting. Jack Hughes obviously going to transport the puck. You can rely on him to bring it through the neutral zone with speed. Wayne Simmonds, on the other hand, a guy that really doesn't want to touch it until he gets down to the top of the circles.